If we didn't have a music program at Frankston High School, I think the soul of our school would be completely lost.
In fact, I think we'd be missing the heart and soul of our whole community, because everything that we value is actually expressed through our musical program.
If we didn't have it, I think we'd miss out on a huge amount of community activity.
If we are moving away from the arts in schools, then we're doing our young people, our communities, our society a huge disservice.
Well, music has been a part of every culture that we can find. We can't find a culture that does not have music. It defines identity for every culture, and so it needs to be part of an education.
It's one of the most powerful reasons I think parents involve their children in instrumental music programs. It's because they immediately start to belong to a group.
They really attain this positive sense of belonging because they want to come to school each day, and they form really strong, enduring, positive friendships with like-minded students.
Music is one of the few things in a school that crosses age levels. So students at the beginning year of a school collaborate and cooperate with students all the way through all the year levels.
And it tends to create a whole sense of we are in this together, and also we have something to share with the wider world. So it's both an internal effect and also an external effect.
I have a group of young people who do what they call sectional practice on a Friday afternoon after school. So these are 11 and 12 year olds who willingly turn up after school's finished, and then they go away and they perform and practice until 4:30, 5 o'clock on a Friday afternoon. Now you can't buy that sort of community.
The majority of our music students over the last 5 years on average have been ranked in the top 30% of students in terms of their ATAR scores. So they do significantly better academically in all their subject areas compared to students who don't study music.
I don't actually see an instrumental music program per se as taking away from the academic side of schools. I see it very much adding to it because it activates a different part of the brain.
So we see a huge correlation between the students that do music and their academic performance.
The research is very clear that students who study music are more likely to develop even stronger neural pathways in relation to spatial reasoning, which allows them to perform better in subjects such as maths and the sciences.
We're seeing more and more evidence that music fires the brain up in so many areas that almost no other activity seems to do. And that in itself has huge ramifications for intellectual development and learning skills across a whole bunch of things outside of music. So in that sense, an education that doesn't have that aspect to it is missing a unique form of learning. It's a way of understanding and intelligence that no other subject actually offers.
The value of studying music for students in the long term, despite the fact that very few go on with professional careers in music, is firstly that they develop a whole range of qualities and skills in relation to the learning of music. First of all, they develop that important quality of persistence.
Persistence, perseverance, not giving up. If I work hard, and if I stay focused, and if I stay connected, that the success will come.
And that's a really lifelong quality, that persistence, which they then can apply to other areas of their learning.
And just a personal story, I have a son who learnt a musical instrument throughout high school, then stopped. But he said to me the other day when he was thinking about taking up skiing, he said, "Mum, I think I can learn anything." And I thought, if we could have young people who, by gaining success in other fields, then believe they can learn anything, we've succeeded as educators.
I've seen stories of kids who could not stand in front of three people without falling apart. And I've seen kids with speech difficulties, I've seen kids with learning difficulties stand on a stage after a 3 to 4 month preparation and perform as if there was no one in the room. Now, in my view, that's life-changing.
There's more to it than that, because involvement in music also develops one's emotional self, and in a world that is increasingly technological, I think it's really important that we continue to build students the ability to understand their emotional sensitivity, and music is a great way to do that.
Often the instant gratification thing can be an issue, and what we're trying to do is teach them that the hard sustained work and effort and joy comes from sticking at something. And parents know that. They know that that's what's going to see them through the rest of their lives.
They're then learning how to achieve success in other aspects of life by putting in the effort and putting off the immediate pleasure.
And you need to be able to work together and know when to come in at the right time, work with the conductor, and that skill of collaborating effectively is just so essential, because we all need to work in teams during school and when we leave school in our careers.
And there's huge benefits for students to develop the skills of working in a team, taking instruction, learning to accept criticism, learning to accept disappointment in some of the competitions that we have with music.
And so I think when they go out into the workplace, if I look back, it's that whole sense of being involved in a music program and contributing to something that is mirrored in the workplace, that is mirrored in university, that is mirrored in real life. So it's actually the life skills that they learned along the way that will benefit them regardless of whether they're still playing music.
Look, there are so many stories. There are so many success stories of students who have been challenged in many different ways and have found their place at our school through music.
It's very important that every student in your college makes his mark in some capacity. And for some students, they may find it difficult academically, or they may find it difficult on the sporting field. And we've had a few instances where we've had students really make their mark in the music area.
The arts are one of the most critical parts of any education, because we are trying to teach young people about viewing the world not in black and white, but in shades of grey.
You learn that the person this side of you and the person this side of you is just as important as you, that you have to be in tune with the people around you. People want to bring their children to our school, in part because of the music program. The beauty of a music program is you can take it and make it mobile. You can take your school outside your school. So an example of that would be our students performing in the middle of Brisbane City, in the mall. It's a far greater value than me placing an ad in the local newspaper.
If people hear a fabulous choir or a fabulous band, they will assume something about the quality of education in that school. The promotional benefits are immeasurable. We just simply could not do without a really strong music program to promote a school successfully. It's a non-negotiable to me.
Because of a significant number, in excess of a third of our Year 7 students study and learn a musical instrument for the first time. And I'm sure many of their parents wouldn't choose to enrol their children in our school if we didn't have a music education program.
You can't just have one aspect of your school firing. You have to have all aspects of your school firing. You have to have your academics working for you. You have to have your music program, the pastoral and discipline programs. So music's vital to be one of those programs that's working for you.
I know one of the things one is concerned about when you send your children off to school is you hope they're going to be in an environment where they're going to have positive experiences. So if one has a sense of the school having a really good community that's being fostered by active involvement in the arts, then as a parent, you feel really comfortable about the kind of environment your student or your child is going into.
My advice would be to start off small. Make sure you recruit one or two really top music educators who you have a lot of faith in.
Find just one dedicated teacher who absolutely loves their music, because we can have all the instruments in the world, but without people who are devoted and very good at communicating, it's not going to be highly successful.
Many, many programs I've observed, not only in Australia but around the world, have started very small. And the impetus, when it's done well, it self-fulfills and it just continues to grow from there.
Have a music parent support group, which we've had for many, many, many years. We use social media and we use all sorts of mechanisms to keep our parents in the loop, because when our parents are in the loop, it makes it much easier for our kids to be in the loop. So the notion of a parent support group, really important. Quality teachers, really very important. Resourcing it properly and equitably so kids can get into the program regardless of whether they can afford the instrument initially or not.
Because yes, there is an element of cost there, of course, and resources and time. So the benefits of the instrumental music program are such that it's worth the investment. My role with Yamaha is as an education outreach clinician. So Yamaha makes me available to schools, to teachers, to help in whatever way I can help improve programs and also to help get programs started. You know, there isn't a school anywhere that I firmly believe that cannot benefit from having an instrumental music program. So I would love to talk to anybody who would like to make use of my services to help build, start or develop an instrumental music program.